Good afternoon, children. In our previous class, in lesson 8, A Great Leader, we learnt about Mahatma Gandhi. Today, we are going to learn about two more great leaders of our country. Lokmanya Bal Gangadhar Tilak and Savitribai Phule. So let's begin with Lokmanya Tilak. You can see the information about Lokmanya Tilak and Savitribai Phule on page 18 and 19 of your English textbook. Swaraj is my birthright, and I shall have it. The person who asserted this was Lokmanya Bal Gangadhar Tilak. Asserted, stated something forcefully. Bal Gangadhar Tilak was born in 1856. At that time, the British ruled over India. British means the people from England. People did not like this British rule. They agitated against the British government. Agitated, protested publicly. Lokmanya Tilak inspired a national spirit among the people. For that purpose, he organized public celebrations of Ganesh Utsav and Shiv Jayanti. Yes, these two public festivals were celebrated in public so that people will come together, stay united, as well as celebrate the festival and will have a national spirit towards the country. He also published newspapers. In his papers, Kesari and Maratha, he boldly criticized against the British government. The British government arrested Tilak and put him in prison. But did Lokmanya Tilak stop? No. But Lokmanya Tilak continued his struggle for Swaraj even after he was released from prison. He spent all his life in the service of the nation. Now let's learn about the great women of our country. Savitribai Phule. Today, we see that girls go to school, colleges, and excel in every walk of life along with men. You can see in these images, women have progressed in so many fields. Today, but this was not so in the past. In the past, women and the downtrodden sections of the society did not have the right to education. The women, the girls, they were not allowed to go to school. They were also not allowed to work in any important positions. Downtrodden people were treated badly. Women's life was miserable. This was a great social injustice. No fair treatment was given to the women. Social reformers fought against this injustice and discrimination. But there were some social reformers, some people who couldn't bear this injustice and they wanted to stop all this wrong discrimination. Foremost among them were Mahatma Jyotirao Phule and his wife Savitribai Phule. Mahatma Phule started the first school for girls in Pune in 1848 in the face of great social opposition. People were not supporting them to start school for girls. At that time, when women were not allowed to read and write, Savitribai became the first woman to teach in a girls' school. To stop her, people created many obstacles in her path. People were not allowing her to go to school and teach the girls. They even threw dirt and stones at her. But she did not waver. That means she did not stop. She did not give up her noble cause and continued teaching the girls in the school. Her nobility and courage will always guide men and women alike in the course of their life and career. So, our deepest salute to these great leaders of our country. Thank you. Let us now begin with the written work of Lesson 8, A Great Leader. Exercise page 17 and 18. The name of the lesson, Lesson 8, A Great Leader. Question 1, Meanings. First one, iron will, strong determination. Conference, a large formal meeting where people discuss important matters. Bothered, worried. Extravagantly, in a way that cost a lot of money. Staunch followers, people who were firm and loyal in following him. Question 2. Write the meaning of the following with the help of the passage. A man of iron will, a person of strong determination. Loin cloth, a dhoti worn above the knees. Non-violence, not hurting others. Answer the following questions with yes or no. Did Gandhiji use any weapons? Answer: No. Did Gandhiji ever miss his prayers? Answer: No. Could Gandhiji afford fancy clothes? Answer: Yes. Did the king receive Gandhiji at his palace? Answer: Yes. Did Gandhiji change his style of dress for the reception? Answer: No. Question 4. Find and copy any two sentences containing not from the passage. First one, Mahatma Gandhi did not use any arms and weapons like guns, rifles or bombs. Second, although Mahatma Gandhi did not use any destructive weapons, he had millions of staunch followers. Self-study. From the passage, find the bigger words that include the words given here. So children, you have to search the bigger words from the passage for the words that are mentioned in the question. Loving, fashion, women, great. So you have to write the answers on your own, read the passage, and you will get the answer in the passage. Thank you. Have a nice day.